A few weeks ago, I went to the launch of the new Volvo XC90 at World of Volvo in Gothenburg in Sweden. It was a spectacular event with a lot of guests and a lot of people, and it was very busy. So I made a video touring the new XC90 on the exterior and on the interior, but I did have very limited time to make that video because, you know, I just had to find a time slot where there wasn't too much disturbance in the video and in the background. So if you guys want to check that video out, I will link it in the description box down below. But the whole thing was very rushed, you know, those events, everything just happens really fast, and then suddenly the whole thing is over. You don't really have a lot of time to digest what's happening. So I thought I'd share my thoughts on the new XC90 in this video, and also compare to the EX90, which I think there are some people on the fence considering both of these cars and wondering which one should you choose. So I thought making a video today that may help a lot of you guys out there. The new Continental Viking Contact 8 studless winter tire is now out, and it's already a test winner. So what are you waiting for? Go out and get the best studless winter tire for the 24-25 winter season. Link in the description box down below. Go click it and get this new awesome tire. Now, on to the video. So if you don't know what the Volvo XC90 is, it's Volvo's full-size, three-row, seven-seat luxury SUV. It came out back in 2015, and it just got a revision this year. That's the version I'm talking about and the event I went to. And it's available as a mild hybrid and also a full hybrid. And I think the full hybrid version, the T8, is what's most interesting for people watching my videos, because predominantly people watching my videos are interested in electric cars. So I've had two of these. I had a diesel back in 2016, and I've also had a T8 hybrid back in 2018. So, you know, I have a lot of personal experience with the XC90, and it's a car I love a lot. I think it is one of, you know, the best SUVs, one of the best luxury cars ever built. I love the exterior and I love the interior. So I think we can start with the interior and the exterior here, because the front end is completely new. So a new grille, a new headlight design, and overall a new design language up front. In profile, the car is pretty much the same except for new front fenders and also new wheels and the rear end. There are new lights, but the light design is the same. It's just, you know, the way they're colored, the way they've been darkened is a little bit different. So the car is new on the exterior when it comes to the wheels and the rear lights and the front fender, but the big news is that front end. And when I first saw, you know, the photos of the car before it was launched, you know, I was sent photos and video under embargo, which I wasn't allowed to share, but that meant I was allowed to sit on the impressions of the car for a few days before actually seeing it in person. And my first impressions of the photos and the videos were like, yeah, don't really like it. I think it looks, doesn't look like a Volvo. It looks a little bit like a Mazda CX-9 or CX-8 or CX-8 or CX-90, whatever they're called, because of the headlights, you know, extending all the way into the grille. But after seeing the car in person and, you know, sitting on the design for a few weeks, I think it is a large improvement. It's a really nice improvement. I think they've taken a very nice and modern design and made it even more elegant. So the exterior with the new colors, with the new wheels, the new updated details, I think it is an improvement. But the biggest improvement is with the interior, because on the surface it may look the same if you look away from that central screen. But the dashboard design is completely new, the center console design is completely new, the top part, the half top part of the doors are completely new. So basically it has a very big update on the interior, where most of it has been redesigned. And it's gotten a bigger screen. The old screen was 9 inches, the new one is 11.2 inches, and it's straight out of the Polestar 2. And I think that's a nice thing, because I think the screen in the Volvo EX90, that 14-inch or 14.5-inch screen, is just too big and dominating on the dashboard. I think this new infotainment screen is the perfect size. And that in combination with that 12.3-inch digital gauge cluster and also physical buttons and switches, much more than you get in the EX90, I think ergonomically, this is a superior car. And also quality-wise, like, it's really nice. Like, it's even nicer when it comes to the materials than the old XC90. I think that is a huge, huge improvement. So none of us have driven this car yet because it is completely new, but they talked about it having new and improved air suspension and also being more quiet than the old model. So, I mean, the old model was already very comfortable and very quiet, and them improving on that, yeah, that's just great. When it comes to the drivetrain, there are no updates, so it still gets that same turbocharged 2-liter petrol engine up front, mated to an electric motor with a total system output of 456 horsepower and a WLTP rated electric range of almost 70 kilometers. So it not getting a bigger battery pack in that hybrid drivetrain or a bump in power may be disappointing for a lot of people. But yeah, it's still good, but it's not as good as a lot of the competition. So there, Volvo are lacking a little bit behind. And also pricing, this new version is a little bit more expensive than the old version, but it's still in most markets, except for Norway, a lot cheaper than the EX90. And that brings me to the comparison with the EX90. So on the exterior, I think the EX90 is a beautiful, elegant design. I think it looks better than this XC90, even this facelifted version. I think that EX90 is just spectacular. I've been watching a lot of videos, a lot of reviews of that car lately, and hopefully I'll get to drive it myself soon here on the channel. But I think it's just the best looking Volvo ever. It's such a pretty and beautiful car. The XC90 is also one of my absolute favorite designs, especially for an SUV, and I think this new facelifted version is an improvement and it looks better. But I still think that EX90 is actually a lot prettier than the new XC90. That EX90 just, you know, for me, it just does it. But when it comes to the interior, I think it is the opposite, because one of the things I have been disappointed about the new EX90 is that it just doesn't look as luxurious, like from a visual standpoint, than that XC90. And also, material-wise, it's not as nice. And that's still the case for this new version. When I went to the launch here, they also had EX90s displayed next to the XC90, and I got to compare them directly. And there's no doubt in my mind that the level of detail, the attention to, you know, different design elements and also interior quality in that new XC90 is higher than that EX90. You can argue that the EX90 looks a little bit more modern, and it does maybe, but I think that XC90 is just more luxurious than ever, and I think it's one of the best, if not the best, Volvo interior to date. And the fact that you can have that new XC90 with, you know, the wool interior, you can also do that new herringbone fabric interior, you also have the Nordico trim that you have in the EX90, but you can also option it with Nappa leather if you want to. And I really love my leathers, and it's just, for me, it's just annoying that you can't order the EX90 with leather, but in the XC90 you have a lot more options, and yeah, it's just better, the XC90. Again, I haven't driven any of these cars, and people have only driven the new EX90, but have driven the Polestar 3, which is a close relative to the EX90, and it drives great, and from the reviews I've seen, the new EX90 drives great. But the XC90 has been improved, so I still think that EX90 is going to be better than that XC90, but how big of a better and how big of a difference? Well, we'll have to wait and see. When it comes to practicality, that new EX90 is just a little bit bigger on the interior, and it being on a fully electric platform, it has a flat floor in the rear. It's just a little bit more practical, a little bit more room in the rear, in the front, in the cabin, in the trunk, compared to that XC90. So lastly, one of these is a plug-in hybrid, the other one is a fully electric vehicle. And which one should you choose? Well, it really depends on what you're looking for. And I think that new XC90 is more appealing than ever. When the EX90 was launched almost 2 years ago and we had the old XC90, there was a clear difference between the old and the new car. But now, I don't think that difference is as clear and as big. And if you're on the fence of getting an electric vehicle, maybe, you know, you don't have chargers where you live, maybe, you know, you just aren't ready to take that jump into the new wave of electric cars, or maybe a little bit skeptical of the Volvo EX90 being on a new platform, a new launched car, and maybe the software just isn't there yet and you want to wait a few years because before all of that is sorted out. That XC90 is looking more appealing than ever, and I think I'm going to drive that as the first hybrid testing here on the channel in a few years. Usually I don't only do full EVs, but I think that new XC90 is an interesting vehicle for a lot of people because it bridges the gap more than ever. So guys, let me know what you think, new XC90 or new EX90, in the comment section down below. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please drop me a thumbs up down below. And for more car content, as always, please subscribe. See you guys later, and goodbye.